Do such a thing.
We did warn you last time, Mr. Paul. Two things make angina worse: stress and physical strain. Just won't take it easy, will you? I'm going to insist that you complete bed rest for a few days.
Oh,
come on,
no.
Sir. Let's get you ready for bed. Come on.
Dr. Cheriton, you wanted. Sister Bridget's found a baby.
Bernie.
Unfold, Mr. Morris, straight away. Let's get this room warm. It's 97 and a half, so there's no serious hypothermia. Could you take his cardigan off, please, sister? Right. Oh, he's a boy. Condition's good. Full term, do you think?
Mm-hmm.
Judged by the state of that cord.
Not more than a day or so old. And it hasn't been cut, it's been torn.
An unassisted birth?
Looks a bit like it.
Oh, that's terrible. Some poor woman cutting her own cord.
Yes, all right, sister. Cover it up, would you? And well done. You hadn't found him when you did, it could have been a lot more serious.
Mr. Middleditch has been informed. The police are on their way. Have you finished yet, Doctor?
For the time being, yes.
Good, because this baby needs warming and feeding and washing in that order, and my nursery staff would like to get on. Back to your ward, sister. The police will no doubt wish to speak to you later, but meanwhile, life goes on.
Yes, matron.
Well. Oh, dear, dear, dear.
Oh. Open wide.
You've got a cushion now, look.
Keep it until I'm back.
One, two, three. I can't stay in. Aidan needs me.
Well, take it easy, sir. I mean, look at Mr. Greengrass, lying in bed like a good boy.
I'll be back in a minute.
You're getting a bit of attention, are you, mate? What's up with you?
Angina.
I've got malaria. Mind you, there's so many different kinds, aren't there? The one I've got is black water fever, but it says in the book it can be extremely fatal.
That sounds bad.
Could be here for weeks, if not months, with a bit of luck.
Now, this is the bag he was found in.
This is the cardigan that saved his life.
At least he was left somewhere where he'd be found.
Well, there's not much of a clue here.
I'm afraid not.
Are you sure there was nothing else at all? No notes, no phone calls?
Nothing. And it's vital we find the mother quickly. She could need urgent medical attention.
Come in. Ah, here she is. The heroine of the hour.
Thank you, Mr. Middleditch. Tell the officer what happened, sister. In your own words.
Doctor.
Yes?
Your lady's doctor.
Oh, thank you.
How's the baby?
Oh, he's fine. He's had a bottle and a bit of a wash and a brush up, and he's got the entire nursing staff drooling over him. So, right, these are our expectant mothers, are they?
Yeah, picked them all out, like you said.
Right, Mr. Carlisle and Mr. Heaton?
Oh, sorry. Wrong pile. Those are new admissions.
Thanks. Right, so if we check for these.
Sorry.
Mm-hmm. Any woman of childbearing years could be a candidate, of course.
No, that's true.
Oh.
Sorry. Sorry, Gordon. Got hauled in to see TJ about that ruddy visit.
What visit?
From the District Health Authority. They're popping in to see how we do things.
When?
Thursday. Don't look at me like that, please, Jill. It's not my idea.
Excuse me. It's a sailor and he's very ill, but it's not him because he doesn't speak English, so I've got the harbour master.
Right, okay, Lizzie, I'll take it.
But he's on the boat. The Russian, not the harbour master.
Right.
By the way, Gordon, have you heard the latest?
No.
All right, Lizzie, send my first patient in, will you?
So, what is the latest?
Right. Oh, nothing much. Sister Bridget turned out this morning with a baby, that's all.
As in immaculate conception?
As in a carrier bag.
That's no good. Tighter, Nurse Hopker, tighter. And we wouldn't want matron to see a corner like that now, would we? Mr. Greengrass, however on earth do you manage to get yourself in such a mess? The doctor will be here in a minute.
Yeah, well, perhaps I ought to have a word with him, because I'm suffering from blackwater fever, which causes anxiety and restlessness. And not only am I restless, I'm full of anxiety.
Sit up.
What?
Sit up.
Where do you think we are? At Crufts? You'll be brushing me down next.
Good morning, Dr. Ormerod. Did you hear about the baby?
That'll do, sister, thank you. Shall we start with the new arrival?
Right, does it hurt here? Yeah. About there. And there? Right, I need to get this man into hospital as soon as possible. So if you could get me back ashore.
No, I'm sorry. You give him medicine here on the boat.
No, that's not possible, I'm afraid. He has acute appendicitis. He needs surgery urgently.
Don't you so do it here? We are in fishing fleet. We must leave today. No permission to stay.
If this man doesn't come ashore for treatment within the next hour, he will die.
Let's listen to this old ticker of yours, shall
we? But if I'm not at home, they'll separate us.
No, they won't.
Yes, they will.
Now, Mr. Heaton.
They'll send her to the infirmary. Please, Doctor, let me have my clothes back. Please, let me go.
Not now, nurse. Dr. Omer's lights are up and he's wanted in theatre urgently.
Okay. Thank you. Look, I'm sorry, Mr. Heaton, but you're going to have to stop him. Tell you what, I'll get Dr. Wetherill to pay your wife a visit this morning and check that everything's all right. How's that?
The neighbour has a key.
Now, relax. All right, I'd better go. I'll come back and finish the round later on.
Oh, matron.
What is it now, Mr. Greengrass?
It's this malaria I've got. I'm sure it's blackwater fever.
I beg your pardon.
And I remember when I was in the West Indies, they told me it can be extremely fatal, if not worse.
When did this man last have a bath? He's a bit difficult about baths. Well, give him one now. All right, Mr. Greengrass, nice bath. Calm you down. Sister Bridget will help you.
Bath, I don't think that's a good idea, matron. It might be a shock to my system.
Ready? Right. Scalpel. How do you do what you do to me? I wish I knew. If I knew how you do it to me, I'd do it to you. How do you do what
still on tonight?
I am feeling. Yes.
Where would you like to go? New Indian? Italian? Down the pub?
Come to Cheriton, please.
Swabs. Yes, thought so. It's perforated.
Looks like Joe brought him in just in time.
When's he coming home?
Well, once he's a bit more stable, he just needs a couple of days' rest, really.
They'll take me away.
Of course they won't.
They'll put me in that awful place.
Mrs. Heaton, listen to me. Nobody is going to let that happen.
People like me are just chucked on the rubbish heap. I'm useless. They'll put me in that place and we'll never see each other again.
How long have you been with the practice?
Since the year our Billy was born, and he'd be 55 this June.
Well, there you are, then, you see. Over 50 years.
If we can't stand by our most faithful patients, then what on earth would the world be coming to, eh? I'll see that you're all right.
2 o'clock, sister, the Elsinby Herald. And then with any luck, we'll have a nice picture of you and baby in the evening edition, and the mother will get in touch.
I'll be there, Mr. Middleditch. Have you taken a peep at the wee man yet?
No, not yet.
He's gorgeous. He looks a little bit
Mr.
like...
Mr. Middleditch!
Oh, matron, I'm just off into town on my lunch break.
I've just heard from Dr. Ormerod about a district authority inspection.
Ah, yes, matron. Yes, I was about to tell you.
What exactly is it in aid of, pray? Why does my hospital need inspecting?
Well, Mr.
Greengrass,
out of that bed,
I
ran your bath ages ago.
I wish you'd leave off. No, look, you don't understand about the different malarias, do you? You want to read this book on tropical medicine?
Bath now.
All right, but if I peg it, you'll be hearing from my next of kin, especially if they find out about it.
Your friend's going to be fine. The operation went very well.
Oh, good, very good. We take him to the boat tonight, yes?
Tonight?
Yes.
No. Good Lord, no. Maybe in 4 or 5 days' time. But tonight is really far too soon.
Wait a second. In your secret. Please, take it. Just to thanks for operation.
Ah, well, that's really very kind.
And you give him permission to go, yes?
No. Sorry, but...
But every day here we lose fish. Our families will suffer.
Mr. Middleditch? Mm? Mr. Middleditch, perhaps you could explain the severity of,
My dear fellow, what have you got there? A Luger caviar? Oh, my goodness. This must be worth a fortune.
Yes, it's from...
Oh, my dear sir, that is most kind, most kind.
Excuse me, you are a man in charge here, yes?
Well, my position here is...
Yeah, you will give our friend permission to go and we can bring some beluga for you.
Now, look...
Well, perhaps we can reassess the situation in a couple of days' time. That's two days, yes?
Hey, come, Ray. Hey, come here, Ray. Come here.
Bit of a coincidence, her needing to come at the same time as him, isn't it?
Yes, yeah.
So, what's the problem?
Hips. Arthritic hips.
I see. Yeah.
And, tests.
Tests, of course.
Yeah.
In other words, you've given her a bed because she couldn't manage a home without George. You know what, Dr. Weatherall? I'm starting to quite like this place.
Good night, nurse. Very well, nurse, I'll take over. Yes?
I was just coming to say goodnight to baby.
What you got there?
Nothing. Let's have a look. I'm afraid you seem to have been...
Evidently. In this hospital, sister, we work as a team. There is no place for nurses seeking stardom in their own right.
I'm sorry. It's all right. Just don't get too involved, that's all. You'll only end up getting hurt.
Caviar.
But it's not just ordinary caviar, is it? It's beluga.
Beluga?
I heard old Middlewich saying it was worth a fortune, and I've seen it in the shops at over a fiver a tin.
You're joking.
And they reckon they can let us have it for a pound, and I'm sure we can sell it for three. All I want to know is, have you got a market?
Well, it depends. How many tins are they bringing?
Well, for a start, 10. They said they bring them in. Talk of the devil.
Good evening, Mr. Greengrass. Here we are, as promised. £10, please.
Well, come on, Ken. Don't stand there taking a lot of no notice. I'm skint. Why do you think I cut you in? Yeah. Buy yourself a sludge.
Спасибо. Пошли. Ivan! Ivan! Как поживаете?
Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last.
Morning, staff nurse.
Bill, what are you doing here? Oh, don't tell me. Have you found our missing mum?
Not quite.
Oh, but have you got some leads, though?
Well...
Oh, typical Bobby, eh? Keeping your cards close to your chest. I do love a man in uniform.
Right. Baker.
Yeah, Moortop Farm. Brigsby. It's under the thought. Might mean nothing.
Here we are. And, are your patients gone?
Ah, right. So, you say the daughter went missing?
Yeah, on Monday evening. Mrs. Baker called about 9 p.m, said Susan had gone missing. She'd gone shopping in Elsinby and hadn't come home.
Oh, here we are. Susan Baker, last seen in May with a Veruca. No. I remember her now. She's a schoolgirl. She couldn't have had a baby.
She is 16.
Well, she's a very young 16.
Anyway, go on. She went missing and...
And we started to look for her, and then early the next morning, Mr. Baker called and said she turned up safe and sound. When I heard about the baby and thought about it, well, she did go missing on Monday.
And we found the baby first thing on the Tuesday, so the timing does fit, I see what you mean. Well, it's worth looking into, isn't it?
Hmm, I suppose I should.
Let me pay them a visit.
You're not going to put the wind up me, Ken.
All 10 tins, without a quibble. Cash on the nail, £3 a tin.
I'd tell you, yeah. I knew we'd get a few quid.
And there's your share, £10. Now listen, if you want any more of that, get us some more of that caviar, because my contact can get shut up as much as we can get our hands on.
Why are these curtains drawn?
Leave it to me. What it is, sister, you see, it's me black water fever. It's a bright light. It affects my eyes.
Where's this book you're getting all these ailments from, eh? Next time you want to invent some symptoms, pick a more up-to-date medical book, will you? 1925, indeed.
Yep. Thank you.
About Susan?
Yes.
Well, we didn't call you. Was it the school?
School? Well, why would the school want to contact me, Mrs. Baker?
Well, because she's not been in since last week, that's why. I don't know what's the matter with her. Her and her father had a bit of a set to on Monday, and she's been up in her room ever since. Her father says she's sulking, but you'd think by now.
Can I go up?
She won't see you.
Yes, well, all the same.
All right.
She's never been like this before. Have to take her dinner up and everything.
Susan? Here's Dr. Omerod to see you.
Go away. I told you not to call the doctor, I'm all right.
I'll make us a cup of tea.
Hello, Susan. I think you better try and tell me what's happened.
Nothing.
Can I see?
No.
Have you got stomach ache?
No! Please, go away. Just go away.
It's okay. It's okay.
I just... I didn't know what to do, I just didn't know.
Yeah, come on.
Don't worry. I'm here to help. Now, when you feel ready, you must tell me what happened. Please.
I have to use your telephone. I need to get Susan into hospital.
What?
Mrs. Baker, have you really no idea what's wrong?
No.
Right. Well, this is going to come as something of a shock to you, then. She's had a baby.
Susan?
I've examined her, and there's no doubt. It happened on Monday. The night she went missing.
A baby?
She'll be fine. She's on a drip for the blood loss, and the doctor's just putting a few stitches in. What about Mr. Baker? Is he coming in?
He was out on the farm when the doctor came. I left him a note.
Did you explain what happened?
No. He'll kill her. Why didn't I notice? How did she manage to carry a baby and me not notice? Where did she have it?
Questions later, eh, Mrs. Baker? Let's just get Susan right first, shall we?
What happened to the cardigan the baby was wrapped in?
Phil Bellamy took it.
Well, can we get it back? Mrs. Baker can identify it. At least we'll know if the baby's definitely Susan's.
Do you not think we can ask Susan herself?
No, not yet. She's in shock. Look, I really don't want to have to put her into maternity. It'll seem too cruel. It'll have to be forcing.
Force is full.
Well, then just ask them to squeeze in another bed. Yes. I know it's strictly against the rules, but in this case, I think we're justified. OK?
You're right.
I don't know how we're ever going to hold our heads up again. We should be telling Susan so in no uncertain terms.
Perhaps not today.
Beg your pardon?
Mrs. Baker, think what she's been through. I think it might be better to let her be for a while. Maybe wait till tomorrow.
And what am I supposed to tell her father?
Well, it's going to have to be the truth, isn't it?
It's her. It must be.
All right, sister.
So are we going to confront her, ask her why she did it?
Sister Bridget, please. Put yourself in her place. She's given birth. She's lost a lot of blood. She's terrified of her parents. I am not going in there telling her we found her baby, if it is her baby. Not yet.
So my little man down the corridor lies motherless, does he?
For the time being, yes.
Well, I think we have a duty to reunite mother and child as soon as possible.
And since when have things like this been up to you, sister? Get on with your work and leave decisions to the doctors.
This is a clinic for ladies.
I don't want a clinic. I want my wife and daughter. I got in from ploughing. No dinner on the table. Just this.
Taking Susan to St. Aidan's.
So what's going on? Where are they?
Excuse me a minute.
Here we are, Lizzie, as requested. Exhibit A. One pink jumper. Hello, Mr. Baker.
Oh, that's Susan. You're Susan's dad.
What's that doing here?
We had to get it back for someone to identify. That's what she wrapped the baby in, you see.
Excuse me, Lizzie, I think perhaps...
She wrapped the what?
The...
Lizzie?
Did you say a baby?
Yeah. The one she left on the steps.
What's she on about?
Mr. Baker, I think perhaps we best talk to one of the doctors.
It's all right, I'll explain.
Where's Susan?
We can't see her till tomorrow, Norman.
What?
She's had a baby.
Good night, Ada, love. She usually has a cup of tea before she settles down.
We're looking after her now, not you, Mr. Heaton.
I love my girl!
Shh,
excuse me, sister.
Matron.
Madame. Ja, a cherubim.
We take my friend now, please. Oh, he's very homesick. He wants to be with family. He's long enough here, yes?
He's certainly not long enough here. Your colleague has abdominal stitches and needs to lie still for at least another day.
Tomorrow, then.
If Dr. Ormerod agrees, it may be possible.
Maybe possible.
Hey, not Governor.
Yeah?
Can you get us any more of that caviar?
How much do you want?
So much as you can get.
I will do my very best for you, Mr. Greengrass.
Come on, dear. It's no use burying your head in the sand and pretending it didn't happen. You've had a baby. I think you'll feel an awful lot better if you talk about it. You had him 3 days ago, yes? On your own somewhere. And then you did a clever thing. You couldn't take him home, so you left him here. Susan?
Is he dead?
No, of course he isn't.
Why hasn't anyone mentioned him?
Well, we didn't think you were well enough. He's absolutely fine. He's a lovely, healthy baby. Tell me about having him, dear. Was it somewhere at home?
On the beach.
On the beach?
Well, it got dark and I went under the pier. I wrapped him up in my cardigan. I didn't know what else to do. Where is he?
He's just along the corridor. Oh. Do you want to see him?
No.
Okay, so you were born in Guildford and you trained in London.
Mm-hmm.
So the $64 million question is, what are you doing here?
Well,
why a cottage hospital in the North Riding? I mean, why come to a backwater like this?
I don't see it as a backwater.
Oh, come on. You could have gone anywhere. Posh job in a major teaching hospital.
I didn't want any of that. Look. What I like so much when I heard about this place was being able to do everything. Being a GP and seeing patients in their own homes. Looking after them if they come to hospital. Operating on them if they need surgery. Dealing with them if they come into casualty. It's fantastic. It's what I came into medicine for. Sorry, am I boring you?
No.
I know you think I'm crazy, and perhaps I am. But I don't think so.
Good. Now, where's this restaurant?
Come on, I'm starving.
Today's the day, Ken. The visitation from on high. And I want you with us at all times, plus a full set of keys.
Yes, Mr. Middleditch.
2 p.m. on the dot at reception.
Yes, Mr. Middleditch.
Looking your smartest.
Yes, Mr. Middleditch.
Good morning. Good morning, Mr.
Middleditch. Yes, Alan Morris, what can I do for you?
Mr. Greengrass wants a word with you.
He would. Here. Well, go on.
There we are, Mr. Heaton. All comfy.
Thank you, yes.
And I've some good news for you. Dr. Ormerod says you're so much better you can go home.
Today?
Later on this afternoon. Not yet. We've important visitors coming and Matron doesn't want people milling around making the place look untidy.
Oh.
Now, when you do go home, don't you dare start overdoing it again. Because that's what got you in here in the first place, wasn't it? Overdoing it and fretting?
Only about Ada.
There's no need, Mr. Heaton. You do a grand job looking after her. Everybody thinks so.
Do they? Of
course they do. And no one's going to let you be separated, Mr. Heaton. No one. So put that worry right out of your mind.
Thank you, nurse.
I'll bring your clothes back after the inspectors have been. All right?
Thank you.
You rang, my lad?
The hammer and sickles are bringing in a load this afternoon.
How do you mean a load?
100 tins. And they want paying on the nail, so we need 100 quid.
100 quid?
By 2 o'clock.
But I can't do that. That's when the inspectors are coming.
Don't worry about them. Just bring the cash.
You've got no work to do, Mr. Hopcock?
Just a sec, sister. I'm... Right, you give me that tenner I gave you yesterday. Gonna need it.
It didn't last long.
I'm sorry, love. The beds are so close, I can't help hearing.
It's all right.
A little boy, was it? I had a little boy once, Billy, a lovely baby. People used to stop in the street to admire him. He was born just as the Great War began. George went off to France and me and Billy were on our own for 5 whole years.
Will he come and see you?
No. He was in the RAF, you see. In the last war. Go and see your baby, love.
I can't.
He's only just along the way. Nobody will know.
Ada! We're going home.
I'll do it, Mrs. Heaton. Oh.
Good girl.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, George, we're going home. Doctor told me.
Come in, dear. Sit down. Make you all nice for Mummy, will we? I never had babies. Well, it doesn't really go with being a nun. Here. You're a very lucky girl.
£60, £70. How much have you got in the post office?
About £50.
Good. Go and get 30 out, take this and give the lot to Greengrass. Come on, by the end of the day, that 30 will have doubled. Come on, Alan, they're going to be here in half an hour.
Who was he then?
Come along, Susan. Look, if she doesn't want to tell you. Never been so ashamed in all my life.
You've brought disgrace on this whole family, you have. The very least you can do is tell us his name.
Martin.
Martin Pierce!
Right.
I've got better things to do with my time than this, Mr. Middleditch.
It's all in a good cause, matron. If they like what they see, they won't bother us again. And I must say that everything looks absolutely splendid. Ah, Lizzie, I'll be in my office. Let me know as soon as they arrive.
Now! Right, so where's this baby then?
You're not seeing any baby. Not until you've told us what you're going to do about it.
And I'm not saying what I'm going to do, Mr. Baker. Not till I know it's our Martins. What are you two gawping at?
I beg your pardon.
Push off! Well, it's only her word, isn't it?
You just take that back.
Come on. You're not telling me our Martin's the only lad she's ever been with.
Get off! Now, now, stop that at once.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Welcome to St. Aidan's. Now, if you will just come this way.
What is the meaning of this appalling behaviour? I think you'd all better come with me.
Hey, hang on. This is the same. They're different tints to before.
It's better!
What's going on?
I'm really sorry, Sister Bridget, but it's the Russians. They're celebrating Miss Riven's discharge.
The best Russian caviar, better than beluga for the same price.
Alan, get rid of this stuff at once.
Well, it is the same price. I'm not paying more than a quid a tin.
It is bargain. Big bargain.
And stop that noise. I will not have squeeze box on my ward.
This is Milner, our men's ward.
Mind your backs, coming through.
Mr. Greengrass.
And this is Sister Bridget. Sister Bridget has been with us now
100 pounds, please.
How long is this, sister?
Thank you.
9 years, isn't it?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, thank you. Berkeley. Don't worry, sister, we have no pain. Thank you very much, Mr. Middleditch. Thank you. This is very good stuff, as I promise. But don't tell anybody, please, because everybody will want some. Всё хорошего, товарищи, всё, всего хорошего, всего.
Пошли, пошли, пошли.
All right, Mr. Baker. We'll do the right thing. Martin will wed her as soon as possible.
Dad!
You made your bed, son. Now you must lie in it.
Yeah, but what about school? What about me O-levels?
You'll have to forget all that, won't you? Get yourself a job. Take on your responsibilities like a man.
Are you off, then, Claude?
Nah, not off. As soon as I get my share from Ken out of that stuff we got from the Russians.
It's disgusting.
It might be to you and me, mate, but it's a delicacy to some people.
A delicacy? You must be joking. When I was in the Merchant Navy, we had that stuff them Ruskies brought all the time on the Murmansk rum. It's whale meat.
Don't tell Dad.
It's whale meat, I'm telling you. I'd know that tin anywhere.
We pack the eggs into the stocking like this, you see? 12 at a time, enough for Milner and Fawcett. Into the washer it goes, like so.
Well, as you can see, another very bright and airy room.
Six beds, you say?
Yes, six beds.
And what's been the matter with you?
Nothing. I wasn't even ill.
Well, obviously she was.
Oh, no, I wasn't, Mr. Middleditch. Don't you be so modest. Dr. Wetherill bent the rule so as I could be with my husband.
Nurse Hopkirk.
Wasn't that
perhaps
lovely?
You could take Mrs. Heaton down to reception to wait for her lift. She is, of course, going home today.
Quite.
Good luck, love.
Which doctor did she say?
Dr. Wetherill.
Go on, then. Tell her.
We're to wed Susan.
Dad says.
7.
Definitely 7.
I make this ward 7 beds.
And who are you?
The baby's grandmother.
Well,
now that's grand.
Congratulations.
I can't let her marry Martin. They're too young. They don't love each other. You'll have to go for adoption.
And that's a wonderful thing to do. He'll surely bring some couple great happiness. Ah, yes. He will indeed. He's a gorgeous wee boy. Think of the joy he'll bring. His first smile. His first steps. His first words. What a gift you're giving. I expect he'll go to London. That's where they usually go.
Come on, get it open.
God, that'll do. Let's have a look.
Makes your eyes water a bit, that, doesn't it?
What is it?
I don't know, but caviar it's not. Are they all definitely the same? Let's see if we can find them, get our money back. Come on, chop, chop.
I can come this way, gentlemen. Along here. Here is one of our capacious linen covers.
Whatever is this?
I'm afraid you have the better of me there. Whatever it is, it seems to have gone off. Any ideas, Ken?
Hey! Hey! Aidan! Come here!
I want to work!
It's not the same stuff! Come here!
Do.
What do you mean, we? I'm going back to bed. You better sort it out with Ken Upkirk.
I think I'm going to have another relapse. This time it could be a real one.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Middleditch. Most interesting.
A pleasure.
We'll be in touch shortly.
Well, it could have been worse.
How, pray? Take him. Love, that's all you need. The rest will be easy, I promise. Now then, off you go. Now then, young man, go on home and tell your dad a wedding won't be necessary. I won't say I'm pleased, because I'm not. I'm shocked. But I'll not have your life ruined by marrying some silly young lad with inky fingers. And I'll certainly not have any grandchild of mine sent to strangers in London. So I suppose I'll have to bring him up myself. Now, hold his head firmly. That's it. Now, get your hand under his neck. No, look. Give him here. There. Norman.
What?
After your father, of course. Well, I'm not having him called Cliff. That's not a baker name, is it?
Might be now.
So what happened to young Martin? Did he get up scot-free?
No, not exactly. He's got to work in his father's butcher's shop every Saturday. Give the bakers his wages. You know, it's very decent of the Russians, this. Make a nice treat for Caroline. She loves this stuff.
You could get lucky, Gordon.
I've heard caviar's an aphrodisiac.
Right. I'll report back then. Night all. Ah, Mr. Middleditch, how did it go?
Excellently. Very well.
Actually, Gordon, not at all well. I've just had a phone call from the treasurer's office. They want to come back for a second look.
No.
I'm afraid our future hangs very much in the balance. Keep it to yourself. Well done, everybody.
What about me 30 quid?
Never mind your 30, what about my 60?
What are we gonna do?
Green grass.
Somebody's got themselves pinned under a train or something at Elsinby station.
You can't stop the 11:29. It's an express.
I don't care if it's a Flying Scotsman. If that train comes through here, this lot's going to come crashing down.
The first results of your blood test do suggest there's more to it than just an infection. It might be worth doing a biopsy.